Dear students, let's discuss another important rule for differentiation, that is chain rule for differentiation. You just keep in mind that this rule, chain rule, is used when there is function in function. Whenever there is a form like a function contains another function in its argument, then for its differentiation we use chain rule. Like for example of function in function, if we talk about examples of cases, just by looking at which we will be able to recall that now we are required to use chain rule. Or like say for example you are given with y is equals to sine of x square plus 3x plus 5. Here you can see that the primary function is a trigonometric function, but in its argument we are having another function. Till now we have studied that just for the case of trigonometric functions, it is y is equals to sin x. The argument is just a variable. But here the argument contains a complete function in form of the free variable or independent variable. Like another function can be given as ln of sin x. Till now we have studied as natural log as y equal to ln of x, but instead of x we are having another function. So in the logarithmic function we are having a trigonometric function. So this is a case of function in function. Similarly we can write y is equal to say tan of cos x. Again in a trigonometric function another trigonometric function is given. Like if we are given with cos to power 4x plus sin square x to whole power 3 by 2. Here this is a trigonometric relation, but the whole power 3 by 2 gives us an idea about an algebraic function. When our powers are constant, we talk in terms of algebraic functions when are used in case of differentiation in physics. So these are the cases of function in function whenever chain rule is used. Now we are going to discuss how to differentiate these cases whenever there is function in function by using chain rule. Let's discuss the process of chain rule differentiation. Chain rule and differentiation. So, in case of function and function, we substitute the internal function by a new variable and differentiate the main function with respect to this new variable. This is the process by which we start the chain rule differentiation. Let's discuss with an example. See, you are given with the if y is equals to sine of x square plus 3x plus 5, just which we have taken on the previous page. We are given with y is sine of x square plus 3x plus 5 and we are required to find dy by dx. Here what I will do is, in the mean trigonometric function, the internal function is an algebraic function. So I will substitute this internal function by a new variable. Let t is equals to x square plus 3x plus 5. So if I put here t, this will become y is equals to sin t. Now you can see y is expressed in form of a simple trigonometric function of variable t. So here I can differentiate the value of y with respect to t. So here by differentiating y with respect to t, I will get dy by dt as cos t by direct formula of trigonometric differentiation. And here we are having the value of t in terms of x. So we can differentiate it with respect to x. So this will give us dt by dx, which will be 2x plus 3. Now you can see, we are required to find dy by dx. And we are having the value of dy by dt and dt by dx. What will happen if we multiply the two? Carefully imagine the situation. when we multiply these two, this dt dt will get cancelled out and we are getting dy by dx. This is what exactly we call chain rule. Chain rule says here dy by dx is equals to dy by dt multiplied by dt by dx. If you put both the values, you will get dy by dt is cos t, but t is a variable which we have substituted. We need the result in terms of x only. So here we need to put the value of x over here. It will be cos of x square plus 3x plus 5 multiplied by dt by dx is 2x plus. This is the answer to our result. And this is the result for differentiation of sine of x square plus 3x plus 5. This is the value of our dy by dx which was required. Just have a careful look on it. We'll discuss few more examples based on. Let's take another example to understand chain rule differentiation. We are given with y is equals to ln of sine x and we are required to find dy by dx. Here, I think all of you understood sine x is the internal function within the mean function of natural log. Here we substitute let t is equals to sine x. So this will become y is equals to ln of t. Here we can get the value of dy by dt as y is expressed in terms of t. So this will be 1 by t. Here we can get the value of dt by dx. This will be cos x. From these two we can simply get the value of dy by dx by multiplying these two values. As we have studied, dy by dx is dy by dt into dt by dx. So we multiply the two, it will give you dy by dx is 1 by t. Always remember t is the variable which we have substituted in the solution. It was not given in the question. So we need to express our answer only in terms of the variables which are specified in the question. So if we differentiate it, it will give us 1 upon t is sine x multiplied by dt by dx is cos x. The result is cot x, which is the answer to differentiation of ln of sine x. Let's take up one more example where we try to apply chain rule directly without keeping substitution on paper. Like if you are given with y is equals to sine of 10x and we are required to find dy by dx. Here, all of you understood that 10x is an internal function. So in my mind, I suppose say it is t. So y can be written as sine t. Now, if I calculate dy by dx, this must be dy by dt multiplied by dt by dx. So, it is sine of 10x. So, what will be the differentiation of sine of t? It is cos of t, where t is 10x. I have to multiply it with the differentiation of t, which is 10x. So, differentiation of 10x here is sec square x. Directly, this is the answer to my question. Here you can just see how directly I have applied chain rule differentiation. I have kept this 10x as t in my mind. So it is sin t, differentiation of sin t is cos t. Then I have to multiply it with the differentiation of t. So here I have supposed 10x as t, so its differentiation is sec square x. Let's take up one more example for direct application of chain rule. See, you are given with y is equals to root of cos x. And we are required to find dy by dx. Here, if I directly write the value of dy by dx, I'll take cos x as t. So it will become root t. Now I can recall the direct differentiation formula of y is equals to root t. So y equals to root t when differentiated, it will become 1 by 2 root t. So the differentiation of root t will be 1 upon 2 root of cos x multiplied by differentiation of cos x, which is minus sin x. So my result is minus sin x upon 2 root of cos x. This is the answer to the differentiation of root cos x. We'll take up some more examples, but I would like you to carefully revise this chain rule once again, at least twice, because this is the most important rule which is going to be used in physics maximum number of times.